Good evening, everyone. My name is Amandeep Kaur. I'm a research scholar at the Department of Forensic Science, doing PhD under the supervision of Dr. Mukesh Kumar Thakkar in the Punjabi University only. I feel obliged to be the part of this conference. Thank you for providing me such an opportunity. I'm here to tell something about personal identification from examination answer sheets, which is a major challenge these days. A number of frauds or impersonation cases are going on. So I would be telling all those aspects, how we did DNA profiling from the examination answer sheets. I will be covering in this poster. So as we all know that the documents such as those of answer sheets can be found in the cases of impersonation, frauds, threats, kidnapping, and extortion. And many of the researchers, they are working hard to get something out of these documents. The question document examination is also going on the right track, but we need to find something which is admissible in the court. And in 2019, we conducted a pilot study in which we came to know that 80% of the population which we studied, they have a habit to apply saliva onto the documents. For that, if we are getting the salivary stains from the documents along with the latent prints if found, so we would be able to get DNA out of that. And we all know that saliva can be the best source of DNA. So DNA can be used. So DNA has been used successfully to identify the perpetrator in past studies or in the previous studies, but they were done from the stamps or envelope flaps where the saliva has been deposited frequently. But here we worked on the saliva which is deposited by chance or with the habit. And for the same, we took examination sheets which are used commonly in schools, colleges, universities, and in various other examinations. For that, we tested the presence of saliva first using iron fuming method, and then confirmed it with the use of salivary amylase test. We got very good results. We were able to detect the stains on the documents, and that stayed for at least 2 to 3 days. And that was also a very good finding, which we were able to get. The portions where we found the salivary stains, we collected those portions by substrate cutting method. We cutted the paper. We take a small piece of paper from the area where we were able to find the salivary stain, and we cut those portions and put that in the vials. The DNA extraction was done using commercially available magnetic bead mesh method using Qiagen EZ1 advanced Excel method. And then after extraction procedure, we quantified the DNA using 2% agarose gel, which was then further amplified using Parplex 21 system kit as per manufacturer protocol in GeneM PCR system 9700. And we then analyzed the samples, which were amplified samples, and that were profiled via capillary electrophoresis using ABI 3130 genetic analyzer and evaluated using gene mapper ID 3.2. So the results concluded that 87% of the population studied in the present study applied saliva onto the document, which were provided them to shuffle the pages through. And this finding was a little bit more than what we studied in our pilot study. That study provided us 80% results, but when we conducted a study on examination answer sheets, we came to get a hike in the percent of the population studied who applied saliva onto the documents. I need to mention, for this study, we used 200 examination answer sheets, which were collected from different individuals. And half of them were females and half of them were males. And females were found to apply saliva more than the males. And the complete DNA profiles were generated from the collected paper substrates. Even when we kept the examination papers for some days or weeks, and complete DNA profiles were generated from the same substrates even, and that is also a finding which would help because examinations are held at a certain time and the analysis of that substrate is done after a long time. So if we were able to get the DNA profiles after days and weeks, so this could be a good result. So the conclusions made were the searching method used, that is the iron fuming and the salivary amylase test we applied on the documents before going for DNA extraction didn't interfere with the successive DNA extraction and quantification process. It didn't bother any of the further DNA analysis. Good quality DNA was extracted from the samples collected from the present study. Further, we are still working on getting DNA profiling from the aged and soiled examination sheets. These are my references. Thank you.